Welcome to my engineering drawing playlist. Today I will be explaining apicycloid. In the last video we have discussed about the different engineering curves from the conics group, and also we have started the cycloidal group in which we have seen cycloid. Now it's turn for the apicycloid. So let's see first of all the definition of apicycloid. An apicycloid is a locus of a point P. Here you can see this red color is the point P on the circumference of the ruling circle. So this black color is the ruling circle that is sometimes known as the generator, which rolls without slipping or sliding outside of the another circle. So here this blue circle is called as the directing circle on which the rolling circle rolls. So this red color is actually apicycloid. If you vary the dimension of the directing circle with respect to the rolling circle, then you will get the different type of the apicycloid. Now let's see the problem description. A circle of 40 mm radius is rolling on a circle of 60 mm radius without slipping on outside of it. Initially, a point P is at the contact point of two circles. Draw the locus of the point P for one complete revolution of the ruling circle. Name the curve and draw the tangent and normal to the curve at any point. So basically here three different objectives. First you have to draw the locus of the point P, then second one is the name of the curve, and third one draw the tangent and normal. So let's solve the problem step by step. Now first of all draw the horizontal line with radius 60 mm because of here this rolling circle rolls on this circle. So this circle is known as the directing circle. So first of all draw the horizontal line for the directing circle. Next, give the name as OP. Now draw the arc with random length, but for this arc O is the center and OP is the radius. So with the help of the compass you can draw the arc. On this arc, rolling circle will roll. So here it is given to you, the rolling circle having the radius 20 mm. So I am going to mark one point which is 20 mm away from this P point. So this is the center of the rolling circle. Let's say it is the C or the center of the rolling circle. Now with the help of the compass I can draw the circle, but take care here radius of this compass is exactly equal to the radius of the ruling circle. Here it is 20, so this is the 20 mm radius. Draw the circle so that you will get the ruling circle. Next divide the ruling circle into the 12 equal parts, and we have discussed in the previous video how to divide the circle into the 12 equal division. If you don't know, then you can refer my earlier video of how to divide the circle into 12 equal parts. Now give the name as 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 up to 11. So initially I have assumed that P point is exactly at the contact point of this rolling circle and the directing circle. You can assume anywhere, but this is the better way to assume the P point at the contact point of these two circles. Now rolling circle rolls in the clockwise direction and it will reach over here. But exactly where it will reach, for that you have to find the angle theta. So this is the initial position of the rolling circle, and here it will be the end position of the rolling circle after one complete revolution of the rolling circle. So you have to find the angle theta, and you have to remember the formula for the theta, that is r by r into 360. Here R is the radius of the rolling circle, and here capital R is the radius of the directing circle. Here radius of the rolling circle is given to you as 20 mm, and radius of the directing circle is also given to you, 60 mm radius. So keep in mind that this is the directing circle on which rolling circle rolls. So if you simplify here, then you will get 120 degree. So you have to take theta as 120 degree over here. So now you can measure the angle with the help of the set square, exactly 120 degree. So here you can see, and so that you can mark over here one point, and that will be the end position of this rolling circle after one revolution. Now take the compass, draw the arc with O center and O1 as the radius. So automatically it will pass from the 11. Next, with the same center O, radius is O2, draw the arc. So automatically it will pass from 10. Now you have to repeat the step, O center. Now OC is the radius, so you will get the center arc. Next, O center again, O3 is the radius, draw the arc. Next, O4 radius, O5 radius and O6 radius. And now divide this angle into the 12 equal parts. And that you can do with the help of the set square. Because of you know that in the set square there is a protractor. So that easily you can divide the angle into the 12 equal parts by taking 10 degree for each division. Now mark here C1, C2, C3, C4, C5 up to C12. And here you know that this is the central arc. That's why I have taken C1, C2 up to C12. Now very important point. Take compass, set the radius as C23, and that is exactly equal to the radius of the rolling circle. So here it is 20 mm. Now take C1 as the center. Now listen it carefully. Draw the arc. On the arc which is passing from the point 1. Because of you have taken the center as C1. So focus it carefully. Arc on the arc which is passing through the point 1. So mark it as P1. Now you have to repeat the step. With the same radius, now you have to take C2 as the center, draw the arc on the arc which is passing from the point 2. So you will get P2. Now with the same radius, C3 as the center, draw the arc on the arc which is passing through the point 3. So take care over here, don't make mistake. Draw the arc on this arc which is passing through the 3, not on the central arc. So you will get P3. Similarly, you have to repeat the step with C4 as the center, so you will get P4. Now C5 as the center, so you will get P5. Next, by default it will be the P6, so don't waste the time to draw the arc over here. Next, C7 is the center, so you will get P7. Now C8 is the center, so you will get P8. So each and every time your radius is the same, that is 20 mm, that is exactly equal to the radius of the rolling circle. Now take C9 as the center, draw the arc, so you will get P9. Next, C10 is the center, so you will get P10. Now C11 is the center, so you will get P11. And at last you will get P12 over here. Now join all the points by the smooth curve. So you will get the epicycloid. So keep in mind that in the examination you have to draw this epicycloid only the dark. The rest of the part should be as light as possible. So this is the first task we have completed, draw the locus of the point P. for one complete revolution of this ruling circle. Now second task, name the cow. So you know that if the ruling circle rolls on the another circle, then you will get the epicycloid. So here you can say this is epicycloid. Now third task, draw normal and tangent to the curve at any point. So you can assume any point on this epicycloid. So let's say this is the point where I want to draw the normal and tangent. So once again, take the compass, set the radius as the radius of the rolling circle. Take V as the center, draw the arc on the central arc. Here you can see this is the central arc. So draw the arc on the central arc. So mark this point, give the name as Q. Now join this Q with O. It will intersect the directing circle. Here you can see, mark the point as N. Join NV, it will give you as normal. Now perpendicular to the normal, passing through the point V, that will give you as tangent. And that definitely you can do with the help of the scale by matching long line of the scale to this normal. So automatically you will get the perpendicular line to this normal, and that is the tangent. So here this one is your third task, tangent and normal to the curve at any point. At last, what will be the effect if rolling circle radius is 25 mm? So here it is 20 mm. If I change the radius from 25 mm instead of 20 mm, then what will be the effect? Write your answer in the comment box. Thanks my dear friends for watching this video. Press the like button to appreciate.